All right, welcome back, everybody. We're live on the patio because we have Jim Perez in the house this morning, kicking off our next golf tip series. Good to see you again.
Good morning. Glad to be here.
It's always a good morning whenever Jim's here.
Oh, thanks.
Hall of Fame golf teacher Jim Perez. We always love him because he's just a good spirit, a good person to have around.
Good morning. Thank you.
All right, and just for proof, you recently worked with the Wounded Warriors Project, and we have a picture of that.
Correct. I got to go to the Colorado Springs to the Air Force Academy and work with the Wounded Warriors. It was one of the most humbling things I've ever done. So I'm going to advise anybody who can go help the Wounded Warriors, go do it. It'll change your life.
Very cool. And you're always speaking to different groups, helping out. And in the picture, we saw a blued kind of discs. That's our Flexor products. We're going to be kind of using those as a tease because we're going to be using those in some of our warm-up series, right?
Correct. It's basically your brain thinks that you're going to fall down, so it makes you move correctly. Mm. I mean, that's the easiest way to understand that.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. So we'll have more on that in just a bit. But today, we're kicking off our warm-up and etiquette series. And it's important to warm up so you don't hurt anything.
Absolutely. I think in position training is the most important thing you should be doing. So we're going to go through a couple of simple little steps for you to warm up with. Okay, so you need two golf balls and a golf club.
All right. Okay? I'm going to hand you that.
Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is just set up like you're going to hit this ball, Jenny.
Okay.
So get in your setup position. Now from there, put the club behind, let's put it behind your back. You're going to put it behind your elbows. Elbows are going to hook on. Good. And from here, what you're going to do is you're going to turn this end right to the ball. So this gets your weight over to the right side correctly. This is what you're going to use in the backswing. So now you go forward and you point that there. Perfect. Good. That's the easy one. You go back and forth. Do this to warm up. Now, you're going to the second step to this is if you can't get that club behind your back, here's another way to do this. So now you're going to place it behind your up on your shoulders, and you're going to actually put the ball, one more ball, the distance of a golf club. So you're going to take that one distance of the golf club, and you're going to take this, get in your golf posture, and you're going to tilt and point this right to the ball. This will be a little easier for some of you that can't turn, but the further you can go, the better. Jenny can really turn. Okay, now the other way. Great. So she's very flexible, but a lot of you guys are not. So it's really important that you start stretching the muscles that you're going to actually use for the golf swing. And then from there, you can use different golf clubs to actually start loosening up and hitting balls, and we'll talk about that.
Cool. So how many times do we do each one?
We should at least do it, I mean, ideally for about 5 minutes would be great.
Okay.
You know, if you do five just for both sides, that'll get your muscles started warming up.
That way you don't go to hit a ball, try to use all your might, and pull something.
Correct. Exactly.
All right. Perfect. Now, our next golf series is going to be up at Stevenson Ranch. We have some great video to show you. We headed up there. It's just about an hour outside Merced. And it's a golf course, a public course that's upscale. It's been ranked number one by Golf Digest and one of the best in California. Great golf experience, perfectly manicured fairways and greens. But they don't take golf too seriously up there. In fact, they have a constitution of fun and a director of fun. So it's a great place for events, anything from bachelor, bachelorette parties to company meetings, because they have individual cabins where you can actually stay. So you don't have to worry about where to stay afterward. They also have solar power and an award-winning indoor practice facility with the latest technology and computers. We checked out some of that. That's going to come up in our golf tip series this time again. And you could win a trip to Stevenson Ranch. In fact, each week a caller will get a spot in a 3-hour clinic with Jim Perez up at Stevenson Ranch. It's going to be held at the end of this series in Fresno, Lexus. We'll provide courtesy cars to take everybody up there, and one grand prize winner will get to stay a night and play a round of golf up at Stevenson. So be sure to watch every Tuesday for our new etiquette and warm-up series. And in our next half hour, we're going to show you how many times to swing to get ready, right?
Correct.
All right, sounds good. Thanks so much for joining us this morning,
Jim. You're welcome.
Thank you. All right, Zara, we'll send it back to you.
All right, what a great gift package, too, to one of our lucky viewers. Thanks, Jenny. We're on your side with another live golf tip segment. Jenny is hanging out with our favorite instructor, Jim Perez.
That's right, our favorite instructor, Hall of Fame golf teacher, Jim Perez, joining us live on the patio this morning to kick off our next series of our golf tips. Just wrapped up our swing series. Now we're talking about how to warm up so you don't hurt yourself as you head back out this spring to play some golf, and also etiquette, because a lot of people forget the little rules about golf. So thanks for joining us.
That was really fun, what we did about the etiquette. That was great. Thank you.
Exactly. Yeah, we went up to Stevenson Ranch just outside Merced off the 140, and it was a beautiful location, so all those golf tips are coming up. But we want to show you how to warm up this morning, because a lot of people don't know how.
Yeah, basically, the first thing they do is take the driver out and hit it. Mm-hmm. And you should take your time, first go through a stretch routine that we talked about. Then you start out with maybe a sand wedge and hit some balls with that first.
That's right. In our last half hour, we showed you how to put the golf club around your neck or on your back to kind of stretch. Now when you're starting to hit, you start off with the wedge.
Sand wedge. You start with a sand wedge, a pitching wedge, something like that. And you know, when you're out there at the golf course, you're warming up. You're not trying to fix things. If you are, go back to the range. Just stay on the range. Don't go out and play.
What if you're warming up and you just see so many things you need to work on?
Well, that's going to happen sometimes.
Okay.
Period. Get a golf lesson.
All right, so what do we start off with the wedge? What do we do?
Well, with your sand wedge, with your sand wedge, you're just going to go and maybe just go to a what we call maybe a half swing.
Okay.
So you're going to take the club about to here, hit the ball, point at your target. These are like your real simple basic fundamentals. You're going to turn your right leg. That's a real big key.
Yeah.
Then from there, you're going to increase your swing. You're going to give me a little bigger. Can I have this? You're going to go into a little bigger swing.
Okay.
Can I have this?
I'll take that.
Yeah. So now, I'm going to take that ball away. I don't trust you. Okay, take the club back, and you're going to go, just a little higher. You're going to go through, finish your swing. This should be pointing at the target. These are like really good, simple positions you need to get into. That way, when you go out to the golf course, you don't have to be reminded. You just go up, swing, follow through. Very good. And you just kind of repeat that. You know, like you're warming up, you're probably going to hit maybe 40 to 60 balls, no more than that. That's all you need. And then you're going to progress onto, let's say, a 5-iron, and then you're going to go into, let's say, a hybrid wood. So now we're going to increase the speed a little bit. We're going to take it back a little higher, and I want to hear the swoosh. Yeah, good. So you're going to increase the speed. As you lengthen the club, you're going to increase the speed, okay? So once you feel comfortable with that, you've hit probably 5 to 7, 8 balls. Now you're going to go to the big dog.
All right.
You take the big driver out. Position is important. We're going to play the ball way out front by your left foot, and it's a big swing. So go ahead and set up.
All right.
Big swing, follow through. Great.
All right.
Very good.
We're out of time for this one, so we'll post these on our website, cbs47.tv, so you can remember how to warm up. And we filmed all of our next series out at Stevenson Ranch, about an hour from Fresno. It's up around Merced off the 140, just to the west of Merced. And it's a beautiful course, ranked number 1 for an upscale public course in California by Golf Digest. They have these little cabins you can stay out. So bachelorette parties or your company meeting would be a great place to go. And they are giving away 2 grand prize packages where 2 people are going to get to spend the night, take a friend, and play 2 rounds of golf. And then each week, we're going to give away a 3-hour clinic with Jim Perez up at Stevenson Ranch. And Fresno Lexus is going to give us courtesy cars to take everybody up there. Pretty cool.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. Quick shout out to Ray Salas. He said, please mention my name.
All right, there you go. And again, we'll have all the information on our website, cbs47.tv. Zara, back to you.
All right, thanks, Jenny.